This is the SAP Developer News for May 9th, 2024.
I just got back from Poznan, where we had another successful SAP Code Jam focused on getting started with machine learning using SAP HANA. If you've attended one of these Code Jams before, or you're familiar with data science already, you know that a typical machine learning project involves multiple rounds of experimentation. MLFlow is an open source platform that has become the standard for managing machine learning lifecycles, including experimentation, reproducibility, and deployment. The SAP HANA Machine Learning Python client supports tracking experiments using the MLFlow package. This integration allows models developed with HANA ML to be easily included in a comprehensive MLOps pipeline. You can find more details on using SAP HANA embedded machine learning with MLFlow in a two-part blog post by Martin and Stoyan. They offer a technical deep dive into setting up an MLFlow instance and provide a general overview of how machine learning models trained with HANA ML can be logged with MLFlow. Another popular open source tool that can be integrated with SAP HANA database is Apache Spark. If you're interested in trying this out, please check two new tutorials on how to access SAP HANA database and the data lake relational engine using Apache Spark.
Did you know, while creating or editing a data definition in ABAP development tools, you can make use of Content Assist to insert all elements in the select list. Press Ctrl Space to get the option to insert all elements. This will insert all the fields of the underlying data source. You can then delete the fields which you do not want, define association, and add semantic annotations. Alias is automatically generated in DDL source code if a database table is used as a data source. This behavior is enabled by default on the ADT preferences. Just search for code completion and you have the option to select or deselect it. When this data definition is used in the projection view, for instance, all the exposed fields and the association fields are inserted. You can continue adding the UI annotations and other properties.
Hello everyone. April 2024 release of CAP framework is now available. We have an update for generating fewer views in database with new option to skip generation of transitive localized views. The handling of expressions as annotation values has been significantly enhanced. When annotations are propagated in views, projections, or along type references, the compiler now automatically adapts references in expression-like annotation values. When the CDS model is flattened for OData generation, references in expression-like annotation values are automatically adapted. Expressions in OData annotations are automatically translated to the corresponding EDMX syntax. Now, coming to Node.js updates. With the new database services, you can now specify streams and subselect queries as argument to insert. With updates for Java, we have enhanced index page listing all web applications in app folder. It also provides SAP Fiori preview links for entities with UI annotations. A bunch of CAP Java features are available for development scenarios only and deactivated automatically in production mode. You can now tell the CAP runtime which Spring profiles should be interpreted as productive. You can now choose to deploy CAP Java by means of SAP Java Build Pack version 2. CDS add sample command now generates a full-fledged CAP Java application with bookshop entities. New updates in the tools include cell completion for CDS command using the tab key. In VS Code, test data for your application model is now available with new commands, generate model data as JSON or CSV. The new generate HTTP request command in VS Code allows you to quickly generate sample HTTP requests for your services and entities, including sample data, authentication, and endpoint information. CDS syntax highlighting is now available in VS Code Markdown Editor. You can now try each of the available ESLint rules for the CDS in Playground environment. CAP's ESLint plugin is now compatible with ESLint Major version 9. You can now bind a shared service instance on Cloud Foundry just like any other service instance. You can easily override service credential values with local binding information. The last update is about CAP operator plugin. The CAP operator manages and automates the lifecycle operations involved in running multi-tenant CAP applications on Kubernetes clusters. If you deploy an application using CAP operator, you must manually define the custom resources for the application in a Helm chart, which needs deep knowledge of Helm concepts. CAP operator plugin provides you an easy way to generate such a Helm chart. For more information, please visit the Kapaya documentation. Links can be found in the description below.
Hola, SAP developers. Do you know that SAP API management can support multiple API gateways? In James' latest blog post, he shares with us how you can handle multiple API gateways in SAP API management. As an example, he shows us how we can integrate the API from Azure API management. This process is streamlined through an open source API import utility developed by our colleagues, Thoman and Bibi, and it simplifies the integration of APIs across different platforms. For example, the agility can be incorporated into a regular workflow or CI/CD pipeline, making it easier for developers to maintain an up-to-date API catalog. This is an open source application, and you can find it in the SAP Samples GitHub repo. There is also a companion blog post by SAP champion Martin Pancras, detailing how APIs managed by the SAP API Gateway can be imported into the Azure API Center, which is another central catalog offering from Microsoft. Check it out as well. I'm including the links to both blog posts in the description below.